it's a sort of anti-commercial, anti-technological, anti-sort of establishment sort of thing to do, by make your own instruments, make your own music, and plough your own furrow with it.
They're just unbelievable instruments, and you know, make one. They're just very democratic. That's what I like about it. You don't have to be rich. You can make one, get playing it, brilliant.
I think with the internet, it's allowed a renewed interest, because what was a very, very minority interest, somebody sparked something up on the web.
I was probably looking up slide guitars or something and stumbled across Cigar Box Guitars, and it was a Chicken Bone John, the guy in Birmingham.
I found it on the internet, you know, about Cigar Box Guitars and stuff, and then I made one, like a proper Cigar Box Guitar with a jewellery box that I found.
I thought even I could make one of those. It's a stick in a box, right? And I strung it up and I thought, there's no way this is going to work. And I went, and went down, down, and I thought, wow, not only does it work, it sounds absolutely fabulous. Do you know what I mean? And the way it's dead as well, which should be bad, but do you know what I mean? It doesn't quite ring, but it's... Oh, that's quite a good riff.
A lot of guitar players now are disenchanted sort of with the guitar makers, because people like Fender, they invented the fantastic guitars like the Telecaster and the Stratocaster, which were really designed as an industrial product, to be a kit of parts to be screwed together by unskilled or semi-skilled workers. And now those companies are selling the self-same product, but now calling them craftsman built. And instead of being able to buy one for, say, £200, it's £10,000. It's the same guitar.
So things are going to get very interesting, I think, in America and in England. And so that sort of do-it-yourself ethic is going to become... it's going to infect everything, I think. And there'll be sort of stormy times, but there'll be a good side to it. You know, people will work together, hopefully, in more meaningful relationships, I think.
The whole making thing has gone in completely against that ethos. And the playing, as I say, it's back down to bare bones essential, a few strings, a few chords.
You come up to a concert and play, and you're playing a box with, you know, a few 1, 3, 2, 4 strings on, and, you know, it's just to be able to do that and people listen to you, you know, and greatly appreciate it, and it's just amazing. It's just unbelievable experience.
I think there's a lot of interest in this because people like C6 Steve. I mean, that's the one name that comes up time and time again, and they see him playing a broken down 3-string guitar and his plank of wood, the diddly bow thing, and people say, I want some of that. It'd be nice to get some wider exposure, especially for people like Hollowbelly, who's just such a spectacular performer, and the young guys like Red, who's just full of piss and vinegar, really. He's great. He's so fired up and so enthusiastic. They all deserve a wider audience.
For some strange reason, I'm wearing a bowler hat.
Hello again, another video, having a video day today. This is just a little demonstration of a 1-string diddly bow. The party gas box just lightly waxed. That one there.
go, that's a guitar.